TonyVarsitySportsNetwork.com. We're here at Carver Folk Tech High School for the 2019 Carver Holiday Tournament, and your bracket champions, I don't know if it's red or green, don't make a difference.
Right, right, right.
Because it's the blue and yellow, whatever
right.
the colors are.
As long as you win.
Of the Loch Raven Raiders, 7-0 after a 59-56 victory over Coppin Academy. And I'm with Coach Brandon Thomas. And Coach, just talk about your team has grew up this weekend.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. We actually got in this tournament so we could get battle tested. You know, it's important to us that we grow and take steps forward. You know, I was just having a conversation with the kids that every game is a learning experience, and as long as we continue to learn and grow, I'm totally fine with that. Yep.
Right. Well, just talk about today's win. Kind of a back and forth game. You guys down by 6 points with 6 minutes left. And, you know, with a young team, you know, after a big win, you know, there's letdown, the word, the L word.
Yeah, absolutely. I think I had that on my mind a lot when we played Patterson yesterday because the kids were very up for Patterson, and we did come out a little bit flat today. And we knew Coppin is a well-coached team. I watched their program grow over the last couple years, and we knew they're a high-energy team. So it was very important to match their energy during the course of the game. And, you know, again, it was another game, another challenge, and it was important that we responded. I think that was the main thing that I was proud of with this particular game is that we responded to the energy, the adversity, a couple calls that can go our way. We missed free throws that we should have had. So next practice, we might be shooting a lot of free throws.
Right. Talk about the veterans who kind of helped you get this, through this win, especially your senior guard, Christian Johnson, hitting that big three-pointer to tie game.
Yeah, absolutely. We've been working with Christian a lot on his shot, but ultimately, you know, I'm putting all the guys' heads that, you know, if you're open, you got to take that shot, you know, and we instill that in Christian as well as the other guards that we want the open man taking the shot. So we try to, you know, implement a lot of ball movement, you know, and stuff like that. And, you know, the opportunity called for him to take that shot, and I'm glad it went in.
Yeah, and Cortez, 17 points, and only a sophomore, man.
Yeah.
His ceiling is really, really high.
Absolutely, absolutely, man. Cortez is one of the most coachable kids that I've been around, you know, very coachable, always wanting to learn. He comes to practice with great work ethic. I mean, I can't say enough about the kid. He's absolutely a pleasure to be around, and I've enjoyed having him at the school.
And talk about some of the other kids who've contributed to this great start, Coach.
I mean, 1 through 15, I use a lot of the kids in my rotation because I think every kid brings something special to the table. We had a kid, Shamro and Eugene. They didn't play the whole game, but we actually got into the last minute of the game. And I knew he would be a great defensive presence, very athletic kid. So, you know, I tell them all the time, any given game, your number can be called. Just, you know, be ready to play.
Right, right. And, of course, yesterday, the landmark win, if you want to call it that, beating Patterson 70-66. Talk about that game and you guys finding a way to beat. Patterson's the defending state champion,
right,
number one team in the area last year. No matter who they got, it's still Patterson.
Yeah, absolutely. Coming to the game, when I was young, I was coached by Coach Bates, and I knew the mentality that Patterson has, as we had instilled that same mentality in us. And I told the kids the most mentally tough team and the most physical team is going to win that game because we understand the mentality that, you know, those coaches coach with. So we responded well yesterday, and, you know, every game's a test, and ultimately, I wanted to see to it that we didn't get too high on that. So even at the game, I told them, I asked them, did we win a state championship? Did we win a city championship? Did we win a county? And they said no. So that was just one game. Even though we beat Patterson, we don't want to get too high.
Right.
You know, we just got to continue to play Loch Raven basketball. It's good basketball.
Right. What's been the difference between this team from year one, your first year, to now?
I think year one allowed us to instill culture. Mm-hmm. I think we did a great job of instilling culture. Mm-hmm. You know, the kids believing in what we're trying to do, you know, and I think that was the biggest thing. You know, not so much X and O's and stuff like that. It's just about the culture, the mentality that we want to play with.
Right. Well, Coach, you know, when everybody's back in school next week and everybody around the county, you know, because, you know, you beat Patterson, I'm going to blow you guys up, of course, on the network. So you guys aren't going to be hitting no more, and
right.
Talk about that's going to be the challenge now.
Right.
Now you're not aligned on someone's schedule.
Right. I think I referenced the Ravens so much every practice, and we understand what it means to go from the hunter to the hunted. You know, so we enjoy the role as the hunter. And again, you know, I told the kids it's only 7 games. You know, we're not even halfway through the season. The season's
only a third quarter of the way.
Absolutely, absolutely. We got a long way to go. And, you know, and it's funny because at halftime I was talking about, you know, blocking out the outside noise. We know what we had to take care of inside. Mm-hmm. Loch Raven has been historically bad, mm-hmm. you know, in basketball. So it's our job to change that around, and nothing's going to come easy.
Right.
So we accept the challenge, and we're going to be prepared, taking it one game at a time. Right now, we're not looking past Western Tech. We know we have Western Tech as soon as we get back, and we'll handle that. We'll, you know, compete in that game, and then it'll be the next game.
All right. Well, year two for Brandon Thomas at Loch Raven. Not bad so far. Not bad. 7-0. They win the Carver Botec Holiday Tournament. They're bragging. They knocked off Patterson Friday, and then they capped it off with a 59-56 come from behind victory over Cobham Academy. For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Toney.